Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. I put up painting demos and studio tours. Please like and subscribe, and please be sure to check out my intro YouTube, where in 2 minutes you can find out all about me, where I've been, where I'm going, what my goals are. Okay, last time I decided to do a creative parrot. Don't know if there's one that looks just like this, but I started with an actual drawing of a parrot and then turned it into this, and I think it turned out real nice. I'm real into red-green contrast. This time I want to do something completely different, like they say on the Monty Python's Flying Circus, is that what it is? That British program I liked a lot. I'm going to do something completely different. A while back, I looked down at my paper towel that I used to clean off my brush, and it had such an interesting pattern of colors that I turned it into a painting. Okay, it happened again, where I looked down and thought, wow, I really like what's going on there, and I can actually kind of see the landscape. And the link to this painting will be at the top of the description at the end. I'm going to remember to say that early on the YouTube. Sorry to remember all these things. And you might not see it so much yourself, but if you look right through here, it's kind of like there's a sun here and like liatris flowers. And down here, there really are little red flowers with little yellow, whatever you call them, right in the middle. And I'm not going to get real detailed with this because it would take a long time. And it is a paper towel, so it's going to start bleeding again unless I use a very, very dry brush. And it might not take too much time. I'm not sure what I'm going to do. So I've got another one over here. Same thing happened where I really like. In fact, the one over there I like better. So I think what I'll do is just, let's do some bleeding. Let it just go into there. I certainly would not have this for sale since it's just a paper towel. I like the way the pattern's going through it. But you will be able to get prints of it, small and large, and prints on anything. That's always available. So let me see. I think I'll start where the sun area is and use fairly wet paint so it's going to bleed around, probably make that area a lot bigger, and just see what happens. Well, not bleeding that much, which is interesting. It's a very important water media technique to let the paint move around for certain effects, and I thought I would do more than that. Well, that's cool. If I'm going to have more control, then I should be able to get more of the effect I want. See, if what I thought I'd do is kind of have like light coming from it and not just having the sun, but actually having the light kind of just emanating from it. And I'm real surprised. But since it's not paper and it's got all these little indentations, I think that's why it's not bleeding as much. I don't remember what happened last time. It's been a while since I did that YouTube. I'm going to put it more like oranges in the middle so we can see the sun area better. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in where I'm seeing these flowers, use a smaller brush, and do some things with that. There's some really nice greens here that I'm going to add into it. And make kind of like the rushes and things around it. If you've ever been to Downton Park off of the Blue Ridge Parkway, they have just beautiful liatris flowers when they're in bloom, and I have a painting of that. And that's just what this reminded me of when I looked down at it. Well, this may actually take a while, so I may not do two. I may just be doing the one. Because since it's not moving around, I don't really have to use such a dry brush. And I can really add to this. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, well. And, you know, leaves and stuff. Just bring it out much stronger than it is. More with the flowers that look like liatris flowers, too. A little mush mouth here today. Oh, I tend to be that way all the time. Always have been. It's a good thing I didn't go into acting or anything. They'd have to really train me how to speak properly and not be a mush mouth. Notice that on my YouTubes. I didn't realize it was that bad, but boy, some of them I think, wow, you need to really enunciate. Okay, just really bring them out. Not going to get real detailed with them or anything. I know on paper towel, although I guess it's possible, it would take a long time. but I am going to try to get a good suggestion of them. Poor husband's upstairs watching the game. He is, as I said before, he's a well-known naturalist in the New River Valley, Clyde Kessler. You can look up all kinds of research he's done. And because of surgery, he is stuck indoors. I can't think of anything worse for someone like him. He just lives to go out and study nature. And I was thinking about something the other day, and this is going to sound kind of weird, and I don't mean to defend anybody. I don't know if it would offend anybody. But I was thinking about all the creatures on this earth and how involved we are with ourselves and with our lives and our history and everything. And I kind of doubt that they are. Kind of doubt that. And I was thinking, I wonder what a great blue whale would think of our famous people. How we talk about our famous people now, our famous people in the past. Wonder what a great blue whale would think of one. And just as a joke, I said to my husband, I said, well, I have a feeling that if someone, one of them got real near to a great blue whale, might just accidentally knock it with its tail. That kind of takes care of that. I know that's a weird thing to say. But what I want to point out is that I think we do get so involved with our lives, and it's easy to forget all the other animals on this earth and how important it is to protect them, because we're all connected. And that's what my husband is very concerned about. And I couldn't agree with him more. Okay, I don't know how well it's turning out, but coming along. I think a famous person or a non-famous person could get smacked by a whale's tail just like anybody else. Oh well, people have always thought I was weird, and that's okay. I'm used to it. I remember one person a long time ago trying to convince me, like most people do, that artists are nuts. And I thought, well, that's not fair. I've always tried to convince people that artists are not crazy. And then I thought about how I spend my time, what's important to me, and what's important to most people. I thought, yeah, she's right. We are nuts. But that's okay. I'm a very happy nut. I really love what I do, and I just wish there were more hours in the day. And I think not everybody can say that. I'm getting pretty involved in this. It's already been 7 minutes. And I kind of doing a whole lot more that was there, and it's really pretty dry brush. You see, it is, I don't know if you can tell, but it really is bleeding, but just a little bit. So I'm able to really, really control what I'm doing and it not spreading around. And of course, it's buckling a little more, and it's going to do that, and then it'll flatten out again, but it is just a paper towel, so it's never going to completely flatten out. So I might just do one, save the other one for another time, because I'm having fun doing this. And I feel like it's just moving along just fine. Okay, there's where the little flowers are, little red ones. Looking in the viewfinder, hoping you can see this. When I look in my viewfinder, it looks rather faint and hard to see. But then when I put them on aperture, they look a whole lot better. So I think, oh, good. Because sometimes I wonder if people are able to see these very well. Okay, there's all the little red flowers. I'm having trouble getting the sun the way I want it, because it's really kind of, sinking into the paper towel and not getting what I wanted to get. Okay, I think I'll get my larger brush again and fool around a little bit more with some blues in the sky. See if I can get some interesting things going there. Yeah, that's what I want to do, get more in the sky. Different colors, like it's in the evening or the morning. I think that helps a lot. It was the colors, even though when I saw this, the colors look nice, but at the same time, a little thin. I really am into color. If you've watched any of mine, you know that I just really, really like lots and lots of color. And it looked a little low on color. So, get some more in, get some more into the sky area. And yeah, I'm surprised at the amount of control I can have with a bunched up paper towel, but it's working pretty well. thinking just now about what I said about the whale. I'm thinking, why did I call it the great blue whale? I guess I'm thinking of great white shark. It's just the blue whale. Oh well, when you do something like this, even though there's nobody around, it's still nerve-wracking. I always, even though I don't think it's going to be, it always turns out to be kind of a very tricky thing to do. And there's been a lot of times when I've just start over. But getting more and more comfortable with it. Somebody mentioned that, and they're right. I am getting a lot better and not getting so uptight about doing these, which is really nice. Because, as I said in my intro, if you ever watch it, I am a painfully shy person. So it's really hard for me to talk even on YouTube to people. Okay, I'm starting to really think it's coming along now. 11 minutes, so I think I might still do some more off-camera and make it even more detail. Got some kind of real dark blue flowers over there. I think I'll bring them out too and add some more. And I really want to have more of the rushes and the leaves and all. I want to get more of that showing up. It's not really showing up very well. Some grasses and all. Never know. The oil paintings, when we pick up a different medium, it's a whole different ballgame. I don't know any watercolors that do this. I just thought it would be a really interesting thing to do, to see how it bleeds and how what I can get out of a paper towel. Certainly not something new. I'm sure other artists have done that before. In fact, I knew someone that combined paper towels into paper and all and had them just really coming off of the canvas. And it was a very interesting effect. There's so many different things that artists can do. And as always, it's about the artwork. You know, I'm not trying to really recreate nature here. I'm using nature to come up with something that I think is a nice arrangement, a nice visual experience. And darn, I just don't think those liatris flowers are worth a darn. I think they should come out better than that. Yeah, that's better. I want them to show up more. And I think I'll get out another color that I didn't get out so that I can see them better. Because what I've got is not going to go around them. And also I need something darker for the grass area too. So again, thank you so much for watching. The link to the final painting, and it's going to change a little bit, will be at the top of the description. A link to my Etsy shop, my website. I'm now really doing something with Wix. I have like two websites, but I'm really going to do something with Wix, and people can buy my artwork there as well as my Etsy shop and other sites that have my work.